10,000, 10,000.
I was so busy monitoring the crew, I never thought to run another barrel scan on myself. The effects are subtle and difficult to detect, but there are disruptions deep within my neocortex. However, it's obviously affecting my judgment. I have no choice but to put myself under arrestation and ask you to go back with the crew.
I don't have a medical degree.
Well, scientific background, you should have no problems.
I have my own duties. I can't possibly monitor the entire crew.
Won't be for long. We'll be coming out of a disturbance. Let them sit down.
Paul, I'm asking for your help. I can't. Why not? When we were searching the ship, he made it.
Apparently, I deserved it.
You don't understand. I was on the verge of losing control of my emotions. The treatment of his face is affecting me as well. But when you told me, I hoped to control it. I could prove it not difficult than I thought. The crew is better off than mine.
I doubt that. I nearly killed Porpoise, remember? What if one of these delusions causes me to open an airlock or shut down life support?
You won't do that.
How do you know?
Because your duty is to look out for the welfare of this crew. Why do you think the captain allows you to sedate him over Commander Tucker's objection? Because he trusts you. And you are.
Sure, I trust my
own. A few more couples.
Well, the past few days have proven challenging. Both DePaul and I are relieved that our adventure is nearly over.
We're out of the disturbance. I can begin waking the senior officers.
My medical staff should be next.
They can assist you in the rest of the day.
We should not have stood 5 hours ago.
This could have been
used
like navigational
disturbance. My host's big friend was supposed to be precise.
Not always.
Check one-way sensors. What do you think I'm doing? There's more than a flying discrepancy.
That can't be correct. We're nearly a quarter of a light year from the far edge.
Our current rate of speed, we won't be out of this one another 10 weeks.
Leave the manual.
Output.